In this video, we're going to look at how you can tell if the electrical installation or electrics in your home are safe, and also why your electrician may have recommended that they carry out what they call an electrical installation condition report, or EICR, before they upgrade your consumer unit. You may find yourself in a position where you're wondering if the electrical installation in your home is in a safe condition. Now, this may have been triggered by maybe the sale or purchase of a house, and maybe the solicitor has requested it as part of the sale process. Or something may have already gone wrong, such as fuses blowing, breakers tripping, or appliances failing. Or it may be that you're having some work done by an electrician and they've either recommended some remedial works or an inspection before they start work. But just what is this electrical installation condition report, and what will it tell you? An electrical installation condition report, or EICR as we'll call them from now on, is kind of like an MOT for your car. Just as the mechanic will work through a checklist of things on your car to make sure that it's in safe condition or within certain parameters, so the electrician will work through a list of things on your property, checking that each relevant element on the list is safe and operating correctly. So what sort of things will be checked on the electrical installation of a house? Well, we're not going to go through the entire list, for that you'll need to train to be an electrician, but we'll just have a look at a few examples. So they'll check the incoming supply and metering equipment, making sure that nothing's damaged and that the cables feeding the property are the right size and are in good condition. They'll also make sure that all of the cables that connect the necessary metalwork of the building are connected to earth with the right size cables as well. Then moving on to your fuse box or consumer unit, they'll check this over, making sure that no one's been putting incompatible devices in there. They'll also check the terminals for tightness, make sure that the correct protective devices are present and operational, and that there's no big gaping holes that you could accidentally stick a finger in. They'll also check over the wiring as far as possible, making sure that it's been installed correctly, safely, and that it's the correct size and in good condition as well. They'll also look at individual sockets and switches to make sure that they're not damaged, the connections have been well made, and that there's no sign of overheating on those. Now, with an MOT on your car, things may pass, fail, or there may be a recommendation as something is just within the limits of acceptable, but is likely to fail before the next MOT. There's a similar thing put in place for an EICR. Each item that gets checked is assigned a symbol or a code to indicate the condition of that item. If all is well with that part of the system, it gets a tick. If there is something that presents immediate danger to the user, then it gets a C1 code. Technically, if at all possible, the electrician carrying out the work should correct a problem given this code straight away. This might include something like damage to a socket front or a cable, causing the wires or live parts to become accessible and posing a risk of giving someone an electric shock. If one of the items on the checklist is given a C2 code, that means it is dangerous, but not immediately so, but will need correcting soon. Something like no earth connection to a metal light switch. An item given a C3 code is one where improvement is recommended. So there's no danger to life involved, but there's something that's not quite right about the installation, and may include such things as important labels being missed from consumer units or fuse boxes. In addition, an inspected item may be given a code of FI. This means that further investigation is required and it indicates that there may be a C1 or a C2 problem lurking somewhere, but maybe due to the limitations of the inspection, it's not been possible to verify exactly what the problem is. A good example is if any tests have proved that the electrical supply coming into the property is not up to the standard that it should be. Once completed, the electrician will send you a copy of the report which will deem the installation either satisfactory or unsatisfactory. Now, while there's no middle ground between those two conditions, there's no reason to panic if the report comes back unsatisfactory. Going back to our MOT analogy, your car could fail on many serious points and need a lot of repairs to make it roadworthy, or it could just need a blown indicator lamp replacing. It's similar with an EICR. Your installation might be deemed unsatisfactory for a lot of serious problems, or it may be one relatively small and easily fixed issue. The good thing is, once you have an electrical report, just like a failed MOT, you can take that report to more than one electrician to get quotes for putting the issues right. One thing to bear in mind with this MOT analogy is the timescales involved. Now, you may be panicking, thinking that you now need to get your electrics inspected every year, just like your car. However, the timescales for electrical inspections are less frequent. It's recommended that houses are inspected and tested every 10 years or every time there's a change of occupancy. However, the rules are a little different for rented properties and HMOs, where it's recommended that an EICR is carried out every 5 years or change of occupancy. If you're not sure when the last time your property was electrically inspected, there should be a label on your fuse box with the date of the last inspection and a suggested date for the next one. If this is absent, then it may just be time to get one done. But what about that odd situation where maybe you've asked an electrician to quote for upgrading your consumer unit or fuse box, and they've told you that they will need to carry out an EICR before they can do the work? Now, it may be that your natural instincts suggest to you that they're trying to make a little bit more money off you. Well, let's just make it really clear. That is not the reason. In fact, the opposite is true. Having an EICR done before the board change will help you know about any costs that you may not have been aware of or taken into account previously, and prevent unpleasant financial surprises as the job goes on. How so? Well, if you're having your consumer unit upgraded, it's likely that the new one will include some special protective devices that will offer more protection to your electrical installation than existed before. That's a good thing. But it's possible that there's some faults hidden in your property that these newly installed protective devices will see and cause the circuits to trip off. By carrying out an EICR before upgrading the consumer unit, these faults can be found and cleared, meaning that there's no nasty surprises waiting for you after the job's done. Another reason they'll suggest doing an EICR before changing the consumer unit is that after the upgrade, your electrician will have to test all the circuits they've reconnected to make sure that they're safe. If at this point they find old cables or vital safety conductors missing, they won't be able to sign the work off as safe and compliant. Going back to our MOT analogy, it's a bit like going to get new tyres put on the car and the garage finding the brake pads are completely worn. The positive impact of the new tyres is lost because there's an underlying safety issue with the brakes. Again, carrying out an EICR on your property before the consumer unit is upgraded will help to locate this kind of problem and allow for any necessary improvements to be made to the existing installation. Basically, it's all about getting the full picture of what's needed to make your property safe and compliant before the work is started. And this allows the full scope of the work to be agreed beforehand. This reduces stress, confusion, and surprise costs down the line when the work is being done. So hopefully from this video you have a clearer idea of what's involved in producing an electrical installation condition report, what it's for, and the benefits to you, the customer, of having one done. For further information, please head to electrium.co.uk. All that remains in this video is to say thank you very much for watching.